welcome back to Review Wednesday, and for today's Review Wednesday, we are going to be reviewing the Pack Retro Matte Mini Sets. They've been launched on Amazon as well as on Pack site right now, but I do believe they will be available on Nykaa soon too. I'm going to be including a timestamp right here as to when the swatches will start, so if you are interested in only the swatches, you can skip right here. Otherwise, for the review, please keep on watching. This is what the set looks like. There are 5 sets in total, and all of them have 4 different colors in them. The name of the 5 sets are Nude, Pink Nude, Pink, Brown and Purple. A lot of these colors are new and they're not from the Retro Matte range, but there are some overlapping colors from the Retro Matte range as well. Now let us do a little bit of math. I'm not really good at it, so please keep up with me while I'm trying to explain this down to you. So each set retails for 1,275 rupees, and each mini lipstick is for 3 ml. That means you end up paying approximately 319 rupees for each lipstick. The full size of the pack Retro Matte retails for 550 each. So 550 for 6.5 ml of lipstick and 319 rupees for 3 ml of lipstick. I hope I was able to explain that clearly to all of you. The shelf life of these liquid lipstick is 3 years, so you get a lot of time to finish them up, and because they are just 3 ml, you can actually finish them up. As compared to the full size, which is 6.5 ml, which is more than their double, I'm not sure if you can finish them up in your lifespan. I'm gonna let you enjoy the swatches, and I know a lot of people have questions regarding will this color suit my skin tone. So for that, I'm gonna be including a couple of links in the bottom bar of different YouTubers out here whom I love, and they've swatched these lipsticks and they have a different skin tone to mine. So you can check out their video and their swatches on their skin tone to see if that particular color will match your skin tone. And if you are gonna be checking their videos out, make sure you say a hi from my side to them. For these liquid lipsticks, now let's move on to a couple of more pointers that I think you need to know if you are going to be purchasing these. Firstly, I want to talk about the consistency and the texture. I feel like the consistency and the texture really differs from color to color. The more lighter colors seem to be more liquidy, while the more darker colors seem more moussey and, you know, slightly thicker. All of them tend to set really quickly. It's like you apply it and it dries down instantly, almost instantly. So it doesn't take a lot of time to dry it down, but that also means you don't have a lot of time to move around and play around with it. So it really depends on what's your comfort level. Do you want something that will dry down instantly, you don't have to fuss around it, or you don't have to wait for it to dry down before you can move on to other things? Or you want something that will give you a lot of time and playing around and just, you know, kind of perfecting your lip shape? It's totally totally your choice and whatever you are comfortable with. Personally, I don't mind them setting down so quickly because I kind of can line my lips very quickly, so I do not mind that pack at all. Secondly, I found Pink 3 from the Pink set, which is a corally orange color. It's kind of patchy. It goes on pretty patchy. I had to go over and over and over, and then it wasn't a good sight. So yeah, there is a slight amount of patchiness in that particular color. When you talk about the longevity of these lipsticks will stay on your lips anywhere from 5 to 6 hours without budging whatsoever. If you have oily food, then it will slightly kind of go away from the centers of your lips, but nothing more than that. These lipsticks have zero transfer. They're literally kiss proof. Here is the proof that there is no transferage at all, like no transferage. I know a lot of you would be wanting to know if these lipsticks feel dry on the lips. I'll be very honest, that was my issue with the first Retro Matte collection that came out as well. I feel they're slightly, ever so slightly drying on the lips, but nothing that a lip balm can't help. Just make sure you exfoliate and moisturize your lips really nicely before putting these on. That's actually true for any sort of lipstick. You have to exfoliate and moisturize before you put them on. Otherwise, your lips can end up looking crusty and flaky, which I'm sure none of us want. One thing that I feel like I have to mention are the names. I feel like there is slight discrepancy in the names and the colors available in the particular set. For example, the Pink set has only one pink. The Nude set feels more like a mauvey, pinky toned nude. So yeah, that was something that I wish could have been changed. Also, I wish there were names for the mini lipsticks as well, rather than just naming them Pink 1, Pink 2, Pink 3. That's me, like, for everything that doesn't have name. Obviously, that has nothing to do with the actual product. I just feel names make it a little bit more easier to remember, and it just kind of resonates more. Now, to wrap up my review, let's quickly calculate the pros versus the cons. Pro number one, they are available online and offline. BAC does have its stores in Delhi, Mumbai, Ahmedabad, Hyderabad, and they are coming up with more stores. You can try them in stores before buying them if you would like to swatch them on your lips. Pro number two, you get to try out 4 different colors in one set. Like if you like a particular theme of colors, then you just need to get one set and you're sorted for your color library. Pro number three, you can actually finish up these lipsticks and you won't feel guilty for wasting half of the lipsticks. Oh, they are very travel friendly because they're so tiny, they won't take up a lot of your space, and they're plastic, they're not glass, so they're not heavy. So yeah, they're very, very travel friendly. Pro number five, they stay on your lips like forever. They don't move, they don't budge, they do nothing. Pro number six, they are transfer proof. So if you're going to be having a lot of lip interaction on a particular day, this will not transfer onto the other object. Now coming to the cons. Con number one, they can be slightly dry on the lips, like ever so slightly. Con number two, the texture seems kind of different for all of the liquid lipsticks. Con number three, one of the shade is patchy and it does not go on the lips so well. So that is 6 versus 3, and I hope that helps you in making your final decision whether or not you want to purchase this mini kit. With that, I finished my review Wednesday. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and if you did, then don't forget to comment and subscribe. Do let me know some other products you guys would like me to review in the next Review Wednesday. Comment below and let me know, and if I end up doing the product that you have commented below, I'll probably add your comment in my video, because, you know, just a way of saying thank you to you guys. So yeah, that's gonna be it for today's video. I will see you guys super soon. Till then, take care. Bye.